Consider the following table of values for a linear function f of x is equal to mx plus b, and an exponential function g of x is equal to a times r to the x. Write the equation for each function. And so they give us for each x value what f of x is and what g of x is. And we need to figure out the equation for each function and type them in over here. So I copied and pasted this problem on my little scratch pad. So let's first think about the linear function. And to figure out the equation of a line or a linear function right over here, you really just need 2 points. And I always like to use the situation when x equals 0 because that makes it very clear what the y-intercept is going to be. So for example, we can say that f of 0 is going to be equal to m times 0 plus b, or this is just going to be equal to b, and they tell us that f of 0 is equal to 5. B is equal to 5. So we immediately know that this b right over here is equal to 5. Now we just have to figure out the m. We have to figure out the slope of this line. So just as a little bit of a refresher on slope, the slope of this line is going to be our change in y, or our change in our function, I guess we could say, if we say that this is y is equal to f of x, over our change in x. And actually, let me write it that way. We could write this as our change in our function over our change in x, if you want to look at it that way. So let's look at this first change in x. When x goes from 0 to 1, so we finish at 1, we started at 0, and f of x finishes at 7 and started at 5. So when x is 1, f of x is 7. When x is 0, f of x is 5. And we get a change in our function of 2 when x changes by 1. So our m is equal to 2. And you see that when x increases by 1, our function increases by 2. So now we know the equation for f of x. F of x is going to be equal to 2 times 2x plus b, or 5. So we figured out what f of x is. Now we need to figure out what g of x is. So g of x is an exponential function, and there's really two things that we need to figure out. We need to figure out what a is, and we need to figure out what r is. And let me just rewrite that. So we know that g of x, maybe I'll do it down here, g of x is equal to a times r to the x power. And if we know what g of 0 is, that's a pretty useful thing, because r to the 0th power, regardless of what r is, where I guess we could assume that r is not equal to 0, that leads to people can debate what 0 to the 0 power is. But if r is any non-zero number, we know that you raise that to the 0 power, you get 1. And so that essentially gives us a. So let's just write that down. g of 0 is a times r to the 0 power, which is just going to be equal to a times 1, or a, and they tell us what g of 0 is. G of 0 is equal to 3. So we know that a is equal to 3. So far, we know that our g of x can be written as 3 times r to the x power. So now we can just use any one of the other values they gave us to solve for r. For example, they tell us that g of 1 is equal to 2. So let's write that down. G of 1, which would be 3 times r to the first power, or just 3, let me just write, it could be 3 times r to the first power, or we could just write that as 3 times r. They tell us that g of 1 is equal to 2, So we get 3 times r is equal to 2, or we get that r is equal to 2/3. Divide both sides of this equation by 3. So r is 2/3, and we're done. g of x is equal to 3 times 2/3. Actually, let me just write it this way. 3 times 2/3 to the x power. 3 times 2/3 to the x power. You could write it that way if you want, any which way. So 3 times 2/3 to the x power, and f of x is 2x plus 5. So let's actually just type that in. So f of x is 2x plus 5. F of x is 2x plus 5. And we can verify that that's the expression that we want. And g of x is 3 times 2 over 3 to the x power. Let me just verify that that's what I did there. I have a short memory. All right, yeah, that looks right. All right, let's check our answer. And we got it right.